Let's now move on to the final main topic today. And the final main topic today comes to us from Zack Harris, who writes, "Hi, John. Cyclops never really got to shine or lead the team in Fox's X-Men. I'm hoping the MCU will give him the justice he deserves. I think they should give him the button in his glove to control his optic blast so he can fire while also doing hand-to-hand combat. A scene with him showing off his fighting skills while also shooting his lasers would be really cool." All right, thanks a lot for that, Zach. And while I don't necessarily agree with the notion that build a movie around an action we want to see a character do, I don't agree with that. You do really highlight something to me, though, that I think is pretty vital and pretty important. You know, I've said for a long time that there are many X-Men films that are some of the greatest comic book movies ever made. There's a couple of X-Men films that are better than most MCU films. Let's just be honest. Logan is better than most Marvel MCU films. Days of Future Past, in my opinion, is better than, not all, but most MCU films. Deadpool, First Class, X-Men 2, blah, 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 blah. There are many great Fox-era X-Men films. Dark Phoenix is not one of them. Anyway, and neither is Apocalypse nor X-Men Origins Wolverine, but many are great. But one of the common things in both the bad X-Men films and the fantastic X-Men films that I believe is a common thread amongst all of them is this. There is something they have all done wrong. Even the best of them. There is an element in X-Men films that they have all done wrong. The bad ones and the great ones. And that is how they've handled the character of Cyclops. To me, that if you were to say to me, John, you know, Marvel, you know, Kevin Feige gives me a call if he ever unblocks my number. I'm kidding. Kevin Feige gives me a call and says, John, you know, I'm assembling my team right now to make our first MCU X-Men film. I wanted to ask you, though, if there's one thing that becomes an obvious point that we should start from to be an improvement over the Fox-era X-Men films, what is that first glaring thing we should do? And I would personally say, get Cyclops right. Because all of the X-Men films have butchered Cyclops. And sometimes they've been great films, so it's fine. But listen, even when you go all the way back to X-Men 1 and X-Men 2, the fantastic movies, and you have a fantastic actor in James Marsden playing Cyclops, which you see right here, on this side here. You have a fantastic actor playing Cyclops. You got everything you need, right? And what did they do? They made him a jobber. They had him job to everybody in the movie, including and especially Wolverine. He jobs to Wolverine, and I love Wolverine, but you shouldn't be having Scott Summers, Cyclops, the leader of the X-Men, jobbing, and he just became a side note. Even in that original era of X-Men films, Cyclops was a side note. Ultimately killing him off, I believe, in Last Stand with no fanfare, no, just us standing there, and then he just dies, and then we just move on. I mean, it was in that original era of X-Men films, they so butchered Cyclops despite the fact they did so many other things great, and I never understood why. Now we move into the new era of X-Men films, our First Class era. We got Ty Sheridan. Okay, you're starting with a new Cyclops. You can do it right now. Now we can do it right. And what do? Again, they relegate Cyclops to an inconsequential side character. They tried to give him a little bit of meaning in Dark Phoenix, but even that ended up being pretty inconsequential at the same time. Now, let me admit something right off the top here. My era of comic book movies, which was like around the Age of Apocalypse stuff, you know, my era of when I was really into X-Men comics was the era when Scott Summers, Cyclops, was the de facto leader of the X-Men. He had incredible leadership skills. People followed him. He had a great rivalry with Wolverine, but there was also respect and all that kind of stuff. I mean, that was the era that I go. So I will admit, I've probably got a little bit of bias because that's the main era that I read those comics. But I think for most people say, hey, just generally speaking, aside from the overall head, which is, of course, Professor Xavier, who's the leader of the X-Men? Most people will say it's Cyclops. People who've read the comics, it's Cyclops. And yet movie after movie, and now iteration after iteration, going from the original time frame into the First Class time frame, they continuously put in a Scott Summers and then leave him sitting on the bench. And I would say, and again, I'm only speaking for myself here. You guys may have different personal opinions on this, and that's totally cool. But for me, that's the one thing they've always done wrong. There have been other mistakes that they've made in the X-Men franchise that they've corrected or they adjusted and kind of made up for a little bit along the way. But to me, the one thing they have always blown was Cyclops. And I would love if heading into the new MCU era of X-Men films, I don't expect Marvel to make Cyclops the centerpiece of their movies. He's not that popular of a character. I get it. Wolverine is probably going to be your centerpiece. He is the most popular character. So, or another character like that. I understand that. That's fine. But you don't need to have Scott Summers' Cyclops to be your centerpiece in order to make him an important and main part of your story and not just relegate him to a footnote, which is what all the other X-Men films have done, all the way up to Dark Phoenix. Cyclops becomes a footnote. And he doesn't have to be your crown jewel. There are other stages between footnote and crown jewel. It's not one or the other. You can have important characters while have somebody else be your lead crown jewel character. I get that. That's fine. I understand. But at least get him off the bench. So anyway, that's my thoughts on the one thing that the X-Men franchise has always gotten wrong through the bad films and even through the great ones. What do you guys think about that? Jump down to the comments section below and let me know your thoughts on that, because I'd be curious to know what you guys think.